How do you show two sides of the same thing on film? That thing could be as simple as a confrontation through a door, or as complex and hilarious as the different ways men and women think. Split screens are often used to create tension, suspense, or provide a humorous juxtaposition. In one superb example, the juxtaposition of two perspectives creates pathos. For the most part, the viewer's eyes are constantly darting back and forth between halves of the frame to receive the information the film sends. Because of the ease of this back and forth, it's also very common for dialogue-intensive scenes where audio of the characters tell you everything you need to know. Sometimes filmmakers use this technique in a cheeky way. Director Stanley Donen created the illusion of a man and woman in bed together with this split screen, which at the time was not permitted by the censors, even though in this context of the film, the couple were actually hundreds of miles apart. A juxtaposition can create anticipation, because they can communicate to the viewer something the characters do not know is about to happen to them. Split screens also connect characters that seemingly have nothing to do with each other at first, but let the viewer know to pay attention, because their paths will intersect in the near future. Images within images date back to the beginning of filmmaking itself, but the question remains, when is a good time to use this technique? A good answer is when you need to build suspense. The one director who consistently uses split screen across many of his films is Brian De Palma. He stuck with the technique throughout his entire career. Not only does it force you to anticipate what will happen next, but it appeals to the voyeur in us. Seeing a murder from multiple angles at once distances us from the act of killing. So why do split screen at all, one might ask? Why not just show one shot at a time? Is there any difference? I would argue that split screen has a very specific purpose, and it's different from just showing parallel action. Case in point. I took one of the most famous sequences of parallel action in all of film, the climactic scene of The Godfather, and I recut it as a split screen sequence. Spoiler alert. In the lead up to the mob boss massacre, the script calls for the baptism of Michael's godson and his renunciation of evil, which serves as a counterpoint to the horrific acts of violence Michael's henchmen are simultaneously carrying out. Is the suspense greater with split screen? Or does it reek of cheap instant gratification when compared with the more operatic pacing that they ultimately went with? Certain trends in the filmmaking become more noticeable this way. Francis Ford Coppola and his editor are cutting on hands, relying on them to transition from scene to scene. It's fairly easy to keep the progression of events organized. We simply keep the left side of the frame in the church with Michael, and the right side is everything else. And it also makes the sequence about half as long, which might be good to speed up action during the climax, but for a lengthy film like The Godfather, it could interrupt the very deliberate pacing. But ultimately, deciding to film a sequence in split screen is a decision that you make before the cameras roll. It is a compelling way to show something happening from multiple perspectives. If you're a filmmaker who wants to try their hand at some complex visual storytelling, think of an event in your mind. Then picture how it would look to two different people. It might lead to pure cinema.